Hey, how you doing? It's Emilio here. We're going to be talking about Apple's password manager. Of course, macOS, the latest version of macOS, introduces awesome new password feature. Also, the iOS. So for your iPhone, the iPad operating system, if you haven't tried, if you haven't jumped in and you haven't started using it, maybe you will after watching this video. This video is brought to you by Moonlock, where we do cybersecurity technology for humans. Hey, before we do get into the video, remember as always to also click on that subscription button. Click on the button on the bell so you don't miss out on any of our video releases. For a long time, Apple used to run this thing called the Keychain. Keychain was like a thing that was integrated into macOS. Your iPhone, your iPad also was able to save passwords, but there was always a little bit of a disconnect between the two. So now it's super convenient to use the Passwords Manager app because it's now fully integrated between all of your platforms. There's no need to download any additional software because it's now fully integrated and built in to the latest macOS and all of your latest iOS and iPadOS operating systems. I love it because now you can actually go and automatically fill in your passwords, your usernames, your passwords, your credit cards when you're visiting websites. You don't have to remember all of these passwords anymore. You don't have to reuse these passwords anymore. Let the Apple Password app go and do the whole thing for you. And look, I've been using it now for a little while. I started playing around with it with early versions of the beta. And so far, I'm very, very impressed. I've used all the other ones, right? I've used LastPass, I've used 1Password, and they are great. And we'll talk about those a little bit later on. But so far, I've got to say, just from an integration perspective, just the fact that it's so convenient because I'm built into the Apple ecosystem, right? I've got an iPad, an iPhone, a Mac. Members of my family have also got them as well. So from an integration and from a convenience perspective, it just works. And that's what I love about Apple in general is they make things that just work very, very easily, very, very seamlessly. When you're visiting a new website and you have to set up a new account, you know, you say create account, or you have to set up a brand new email address, brand new password for a web service of some sort, it's gonna, of course, recommend and suggest a very, very strong password. You don't have to remember passwords anymore. Long gone are those days if you're having to remember passwords. It will suggest a very, very strong password and then it'll save it. And if you're doing this from your Mac, for example, it'll save. And as long as your Mac is part of the same Apple ID ecosystem as your iPhone, it'll automatically then be available on your iPhone. You don't have to do anything else other than that. I could then even go to my iPhone, update a password for one of my websites, and then it'll downstream and go back up to my Mac. So then the next time I'm on my Mac, it's there, it's ready to go. And I love the fact that this is free. You don't have to pay a dime for this, it's built right in. Now, the only thing that I will say that it's a little bit of a negative is it is a Apple-only product. So unlike 1Password, unlike LastPass and other password protection software, those you can go and install them on Android devices, you can install them on Windows devices and on the Mac, and it'll be seamless between all of those. They themselves will have limitations on some of their free versions because they do have free versions available as well, but sometimes there are limitations with the free version. So if you wanna get the most out of it, you wanna have the most users and all of that, then you have to go down the paid route. But the only thing with the Apple one, even though it's completely free, it won't unfortunately work with non-Apple products. So as long as you're aware of that, it's a great product. Now, Apple is big on security. They really want to make sure that their products are secure. So as a result of that, the passwords are completely encrypted. No one will be able to get access to those passwords except for you. Also, you can share passwords with family members. So if they're part of your family account, you can share those passwords. If you have a family member that saves passwords on their password app, they can actually share them with you. You can create family vaults essentially within passwords and share them, and they are completely secure and encrypted. It also supports all of your biometric features, your face ID, your touch ID, so you'll guarantee that you don't have to just remember a big strong password to unlock your phone, but it actually uses your face to secure it even further. One of the coolest things that I love as well is that it actually does tell you where the passwords are weak, where the passwords are being reused. For example, you're using a password on 3 websites, it will tell you, maybe don't use this password because it's used already somewhere else. It's always good practice to have different passwords for every service, different complex passwords for every service. And the best thing is that if your password, for whatever reason, has been involved in a data breach, let's say one of your trusted websites that you use, that you're surfing the internet on, has had a data breach and the database has been compromised and the passwords have been leaked, the passwords app will let you know that it's been involved in a data breach so that you know, and then you can go and proactively reset that password. Now, the apps will be fully integrated into your suite of applications and websites that you're visiting across your Apple fleet, which is awesome, right? Your Wi-Fi passwords are also now managed and centrally stored within passwords. So you don't even have to remember Wi-Fi passwords anymore. It just saves them for you. And again, they're synced across all of your devices, fully embedded within Safari, within your browser. And hey, if you're using one of the other browsers, Google Chrome or Firefox, there are add-ons that you can actually use to embed into those browsers as well. Now, although there isn't proper support between Windows and Android devices, there are additions for Chrome, right? As I said, Google Chrome, you can actually use a little built-in add-on. It does have some limited functionality, but it is there if you so want to try it out. There's other great features, including saving of your 2FA, your MFA codes, auto filling up of those codes, great features around sharing passwords. So you can airdrop your passwords to other iPhone devices, other for iPhone users. And I mentioned the Wi-Fi passwords. It actually will sync those Wi-Fi passwords between devices. So if you're on your Mac and you've connected to a Wi-Fi hotspot, you're traveling maybe to a location, to a hotel, to a restaurant, then you pick up your phone, it's automatically going to be synced over to that through that app, and then you've got Wi-Fi access. How good? Now, let's say you want to be using password managers from a business perspective and use multiple vaults and get all these advanced features. That is where you're going to probably have to use something like 1Password, because it's just going to be a little bit better, has integration with your backend solutions like Active Directory and things like that. You're not going to get that as much on the Apple side. And as I mentioned, 1Password is going to have integration across all of your operating systems, Windows and Android as well, while the Apple Password Manager, hence the name, is only going to work really well across Apple devices. But so far, I've got to say, I love it. I've been using it for a while. I've been sharing it with my family members. We've created our own vault. And so far, you know what? I haven't needed to use 1Password for me and my personal life, because I think the password app that Apple has made was something that I was asking for a long time ago. And I love the fact that they've removed the old way of working with the keychain, and now it's fully embedded into my Apple product. So it makes it so much easier. And the thing that I'm predicting is that as the months and months and years even go on, Apple is going to add additional features. So I wouldn't be surprised. This is the first edition of the passwords app. In the future, there's going to have additional features added. So who knows, some of the other password managers that are out there may end up fizzling out if Apple takes this thing on even bigger. But hey, that's my review. Let me know down below in the comments what you think. Have you been using it? Let us know as well. And as always, remember to click on that subscription button, click on the bell so you don't miss out on any of our releases, and also give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. Thanks so much for tuning in. We'll see you on the next video.